started looking at the great story of the Tunnel Depot in our last video, and we want to conclude it in this video. I have a short video clip that I want to show you. It's from 1897, which would have been about 6 years after the Tunnel Depot was built. And it shows the train coming from Sarnia through the tunnel. And the video clip that you're going to see is the portion where it's coming into the tunnel station. I thought it was interesting, especially since it's so old. So take a look. Here you can see the train coming in, going through the different switches to get to the different tracks to get to the tunnel station. There you can see the tunnel station there on your right. And of course, the people that are all lining up waiting to get on or waiting for people to get off. I told you we had another photo of the opposite side of the Grand Trunk Tunnel Railroad station, and here it is. It looks very much like the other side, although there are some differences. If you look on the second floor of those dormers, some of those were bedrooms, like we mentioned before, for the help, but some of them had bunk beds for visiting railroad crews as well. And also the Grand Trunk Western Division offices were up there. And that building that protrudes out from the depot is the U.S. Immigration offices. And let's go down here in the bottom right-hand corner and give photo credit where credit is due. In this photo, you see a lot of people gather around a steam engine, some folks taking pictures. And the occasion was that this was the last steam engine that would be at the Grand Trunk Tunnel Depot. And you can see the depot through all that steam on the upper left-hand corner. August 30th, 1971, a Grand Trunk Western Railway conductor walks away from the last Grand Trunk passenger train to stop at Port Huron. The station served faithfully for over 80 years, but with the coming of Amtrak, its doors were closed permanently, as Grand Trunk opted not to join the newly formed carrier, with no passenger trains and his former office area barely occupied, the station quickly declined. Despite efforts by several individuals to save the structure, less than 4 years later, this magnificent structure was demolished to be replaced by nothing. This station was surrounded by a once vibrant neighborhood, and we don't have a lot of photos of that neighborhood like we do the depot, but we do have a few, and we'll show you those now. As we saw earlier in the video, 22nd Street dead end, right in about the center of the tunnel station. But on the northeast corner, there was a hotel, this hotel right here. It was built as the St. Cloud Hotel, but it went under various names, including the Ken Miller Hotel, the McCabe Hotel, but it was a Pullman Hotel when it was destroyed by fire. Thanks to Dave O'Donnell, we actually have photographs of that fire. And here you have the aftermath, but you can see the signage saying Pullman Hotel and Clean Rooms 1450. Across the street from the Pullman Hotel was the Ronan Hotel. This would have been on the northwest corner. As far as I can tell, the Ronan Hotel never changed hands. However, they did become owners of the hotel across the street that you saw burned down. And they called that the Ronan's Annex. That's one more name we could add to the list. But this name was before all the other names I gave you of that hotel. It was called the Ronan Annex, and the other one was called the Ronan Hotel. I might mention when the hotel was originally built, it was called the Normandy Hotel, and then the Ronan Hotel. Eventually, the Ronan Hotel went out of business, but they kept the Ronan Annex. It was unoccupied for, oh, maybe a year, and then Richard's Restaurant went in there. Eventually, they renovated it so it had a little different look than this photograph here. And in this photograph, you can see inside at the dining room. And here we see it in ad. take Mother out to dinner. We also have photographs of Richard's menu, thanks to T.J. Gaffney. Let's look a little closer here and see what some of these things are. See if we can whet your appetite and make your purse strings feel pretty good looking at these prices. Remember this photograph when we showed that the depot was just being built? Well, in this photograph here, we can see the demise of the depot is boarded up. But also, you can see the hotel that burned down on the left hand corner. And on the right, you can see Richards. There was another hotel a couple of doors west from Richards called the International Hotel. And we don't have a photograph of that, however. And then a couple of doors down from that was a drugstore. We don't have a photograph of the drugstore. We do have a couple of things I can show you, though. Here we have an ad for the Tunnel Drugstore, run by E.R. O'Neill. And it tells all the things that they do on it, and also the address and telephone number, 152. And here we've found that someone has a, looks like a prescription bottle from the drugstore. It says the Tunnel Drugstore, E.R. O'Neill, Port Huron, Michigan. We don't have any other photos until we go across 23rd Street to the northwest corner. And here we have a great picture of the Griswold House, or Griswold Hotel. That's what they called hotels back then sometimes. And look who it was owned by, J. Ronan. At one time, he owned three hotels on Railroad Street. Later on, this would be called the Tunnel Hotel. I thought we'd do something a little different to close this portion of the video out. I thought you and I could take a ride down Railroad Street and see what it's like today. Of course, I'm living in Indiana, and I don't know where you're living, but with the technology of Google Maps, we can take this little journey together. It might be a little herky and jerky, but let's see what we got. Not a very long street, so we don't have too far to go. Now we just passed 23rd Street. Everything on the left is where most of the hotels and restaurants and so forth was. If you look over here on the right, this was all Grand Trunk Depot. You had the baggage sheds, you had the depot, you had the immigration department. As we pass 22nd, we come pretty much to the end of the road. So we'll turn around. On this corner right here, this is where the hotel burned down that we looked at previously. On this corner, that's basically vacant now. This is where the Hotel Ronan was, and also Hotel Normandy, and where Richard's restaurant was. I believe this is an original building here. This is where the barbershop used to be. This one down here is a newer building, it appears. I think there's a bike club that has occupancy there. But this whole area here used to be the International Hotel. And then as we come down to the corner, we had the Tunnel Drugstore. And then we came down here to 23rd Street, right here, where the two streets actually come together, Railroad and 23rd Street. And this is where the Griswold House was, the Griswold Hotel was. And so as we turn around and look back, at one time, this was a gateway to Port Huron. Not so much anymore. All right, as we head back to 24th Street and go south, we come to the Viaduct. Most all of us are familiar with this Viaduct. Today it has no identifying signage on it, but at one time it did. The signage said, Grand Trunk Western Railroad. In this newspaper article, the photograph has this caption, Motoring along, this mid-1940s vintage Mercury makes its way under the Grand Trunk Railroad Viaduct on 24th Street in Port Huron in this undated photo. Well, the automobile wasn't always able to motor under the viaduct because it had a terrible drainage problem, as you can see from this photograph here. Notice in this photograph here, identifying signage doesn't say Grand Trunk Western Railroad, it says Pier Marquette. Here's another photograph from a slightly different angle. Once we go under the viaduct heading south, the first street we come to is Beard Street. If we were to go down a little bit further, we'd come to Dove Street. And if we were to take a left and go a little ways, we'd come to 16th Street. These four streets, including the 24th Street, would be the perimeter of what is known as the Industrial Park. In 1952, the Port Huron St. Clair County Industrial Development Corporation was formed with the intention of creating jobs for the community and diversifying the economic base of the area. By 1967, a 200-acre site was chosen for development as Port Huron Industrial Park. The map you see here was prepared by the Charles Valentine Architects, and it gives a geographical perspective to the Port Huron Industrial Park location. The city would soon invest $545,000 for interior and perimeter streets and water and sewer lines for this tract of land, previously used as the city dump. As part of an agreement with the city, the Industrial Development Corporation marketed the proposed sites in 1968. Today, it looks like this from a similar view. Shown here are Norman Cosgrove, Kenneth Moody, and Robert Patterson, director of the Industrial Development Corporation. These three men were part of a larger group which promoted the proposed industrial park. This group would be instrumental in successfully contacting and secure European companies to locate here. This aerial view shows Port Huron Industrial Park in the late 1970s. Today, the industrial park looks like this. As we go a little bit further down 24th Street in the 2500 block, we come to this place here. Today, it's Faulkner's Catering. But at one time at this location was Sam Napolitan's Service Center. And as we continue going down 24th Street, we come to the southwest corner of Dove and 24th. And this is what it looks like today. But at one time, just beyond this party store here, just south of this, was the Red Shingle Tavern. If you recall, the Red Shingle Tavern used to be in the First Ward, and then when urban renewal came, they had to leave that location, and this is where they went. As we continue down 24th Street, almost to Vinesse Street, on the left side, east side, we find fire station number 4. And this is what it looks like today. But this is actually the second fire station was at this location. Well, pretty close to this location. At one time, right next to this lot, was this station here. They kept this station until the new station could be built next to it. And then that station was torn down, and the area, as you can see from the satellite view, was used for parking and an entrance. We're very fortunate to have a photograph of the building of that first station. And I'd like to thank David Shannon Boyd for sharing these photographs, this one and a couple others. In this photograph here, you can see them all decked out in front of the station. And in this photo, we see a social gathering inside the station, so it gives you an idea of what it looked like inside the station. Well, that's the last photograph we have to share with you on 24th Street. It's actually the last photograph I have in the Portrait Past and Present series, at least geographically. It's been 6 years, 176 videos, 33 DVDs. I think it's almost time to hang it up, but I know there's a couple things I've missed. So I'm going to go back and the next couple videos try to pick those things up, and we'll call those bonus videos, and then we'll be finished.